Hey, it's Nico Tenner. Today I want to show you how I do my asset basslines using Xerum. You can hear in the background how it will sound in the end. It's basically a continuation of my melodic techno tutorial, but you can use this also for genres like lo-fi house or drum and bass. And it's very similar to how I did it in the track The Fall, which I will post in the comments. So let's go. So, I want to show you what we did last time. Now you can hear our build up with the breakbeat, and then we did some very basic drop. And today I want to show you how I do an acid drop. Basically, I'm not gonna spend so much time to do a good transition. Instead, I just want to show you how I do the sound design. So let's just remove everything for now and create a new pattern, call it acid, and then add Xerum. There it is. So what I don't like to do actually is create the different notes in the piano roll. Instead, I just do a single long note, and which should be in the same scale as the rest of your track. Let's say we have this is our arp melody, and yeah, let's do A as a bass note. And what I do now is, as I said, instead of creating the different notes in the piano roll, I do it using the LFO editor. And for this, I will route the LFO to the semitones of the oscillator. And then pressing shift, I do something like stairs, basically. Those are some different notes. And now it will sound like this, which is obviously too fast, so I will turn down the rate. Now we have something like this. I think in the LFO editor, the middle line is actually the bass note which you chose here, so I would try to keep the notes centered around this, something like this for example. And I think each line is two semitones, so you have to try to stay in the scale of the track with these lines. For now, we can do something like this, and it will sound okay on its own, but it will probably not fit to the melody right now. So that's something you have to look out for. We will not do it right now because it will just waste time. And yeah, now let's turn down the octaves a bit, something like this. And what we can do now is actually route this LFO to different other parameters, for example the filter. Now we have something like this, and it sounds already more like acid. Now we can do this with a lot of different parameters. And if we want to add another oscillator, we of course have to also route it to the semitones again. And now you can choose different sound design combinations, for example, add some distortion. And you could also add the same LFO to the filter cutoff frequency. Oh, of course you have to turn it on. But since this is pretty random, this might sound a little weird, so I'm gonna remove this and use another LFO. And basically put it on the same rate as a one step of these would be. So we have 8 steps in a half rate, so we should do 16. Now you can, instead of routing this LFO to the cutoff, also use this one. And yeah, you can experiment with different parameters. I personally like using this LFO on the cutoff though. It just gives it a little more randomness. And another great thing to do is frequency modulation. For example, we route this LFO through this one, not LFO, oscillator of course, and we can just, for example, choose square wave. And now we can experiment with more cutoff. Now this is very, you need a lot of fine tuning to get a great sound, and you can you can layer as many effects on it as you want. Maybe use a different sound. Something like this. And of course we already have our sidechain channel, so let's route this asset baseline into another mixer channel and put it through the sidechain. Now we have something like this. Oh, let's remove this. And as always, now we can create some automation on the different values. The classic one is cutoff automation. But you can also automate the actual amount of the LFO on the parameter. So if you move this button here, or knob rather, and then go to last tweaked and create an automation clip, you can also automate this. Oops. And yeah, now you can experiment with a lot of different things. Just within Serum. But when you are done, you can of course also add some other effect plugins. A classic one is another low pass on here. For very, very basic rise effects. And if you want to give your baseline this screaming sound, you can turn up the resonance, for example. And I think if you combine the resonance with the, god damn it, it always hides. Yeah, with the drive, you can get some, or the fatness, you can get some pretty dirty sounds. You can just try moving different knobs, and if you find a nice combination, you can then put them into an automation clip. And another thing you can do is, of course, route two different LFOs on the same value, so we have some different movements, as you can hear now. I don't think there's an actual way to automate this movement, sadly. You can also turn off the BPM sync and put the rate on random values, basically. So you can do all kinds of different build-ups, breakdowns and stuff. And now let's turn this back. Remove. We can actually start to sync this up to our track. And this actually kinda works. Now we can do this build up of the asset baseline already in this part, so it has a transition. Put all these automation clips on here, and maybe also a simple volume automation. And now we have something like this. It helps if you start putting another one of these synths down at the same time, so you don't have too many clashing frequencies. Now you should of course try to make the transition not too abrupt, so you can keep on playing, for example, the lead synth. But you can choose a different melody, so whoops, let's make it unique and a different pattern. Maybe just do the same chord. And maybe put the decay even more down, wet level completely down, something like this. And for example here you can now add something like hats to make it give it a heavier sound, something very simple. Gonna use stock sample, do it on each kick. And now you can turn up more parameters over time, so it gets heavier and heavier. For example, the drive of the distortion. So you have basically two parts, like in the track I showed you in my last tutorial, the fall. I can link it in the comments, so you can check it out. Of course, you have to make sure that you mix it correctly. The more distortion you add, the harder it gets to mix it well. But I will not show you how to mix correctly in this tutorial because that would take too much time. So yeah, now we have basically two parts where we start with a simple melodic intro. Have this very, I'm not sure how to call it, maybe even ambient breakdown. And something like a pretty hard drop. Of course, you can use these techniques also for different types of music. For example, some lo-fi. If you use it in a different BPM, it works as well. I'm sure most of you checked out my lo-fi tutorial already. So you can also use some breakbeats and acid in there too. Sounds very great actually. So that was it for today, and thanks for watching again.